Now we are going to discuss a relation in potential energy and forces. My dear friends, I think we already studied that when we talk about the term potential energy, this implies we are talking about conservative forces. Because we have studied very well earlier that in case of non-conservative forces, no storage of energy is possible. Full work done or whole amount of work done is dissipated in form of energy loss. Whenever we talk about potential energy or a stored form of energy, it implies we are talking about conservative forces. And in case of conservative forces, work done is always stored in form of potential energy. Whatever work is done is equal to change in potential energy. As we have studied, delta W is equals to delta U. Let us take up an example. Say this is a conservative field. In this conservative field, let us divide it in two parts. On left part, there is say a point A. On right part, there is say a point B. When a body is placed at point A, its energy is UA. And when the same body is placed at B, say its energy is UB. And we are given that UA is more than UB. Here we can see at position B the energy is less, at position A if potential energy is more. If a body is placed at point A, we all know that every body has a tendency to achieve lowest possible energy state, which implies high stability. So we can say this region, the right half of this conservative field is more stable as compared to left half because here energies are less. So when we just place a body over here and we release it, as it is having lesser energy over here, the body will have a tendency to directly move to the lower energy states. Or we can say when we release it, this field will exert a conservative field force toward the direction of low energy state. The simplest example for this is, if we are having a ground, we release a body from a height above the ground. We all know very well, as soon as we release, mg will act on it in downward direction, the body will fall towards lower positions. The reason is, if this position x, this position y, the potential energy at position x is more than potential energy of body at position y. So automatically gravitational field is exerting a force on body in such a way so as to bring it toward low energy states. Because gravitational field is a conservative field. Here we can simply state gravitational field is a conservative field. Similarly, in any conservative field, when you release a body from a position, it will always experience a force in that direction where potential energy of body is decreasing. And when the body starts moving from this position to this position, this force will do work, and whatever work is done in bringing the body from this position, that will be the loss in potential energy. So we can simply state a work done in going A to B by force. This can simply be written as this delta W is equals to loss in energy of system as at B energy is less. So whatever energy is decreased, that is the work done. We can write it UA minus UB. That we already studied that in case of conservative field, work done depends only on the initial and final energy, is not on the path along which it is taken. So in this situation, this work, if we calculate mathematically, this delta W can be written as integration of F dot dx will be taken from point A to point B. Now, similarly, if we talk that we are taking this body from this point, the potential energy will be decreasing. So we can very easily write whatever work is done, it is equals to minus of delta U. Negative sign shows that energy is decreasing. The same thing we can analyze for elementary steps. If body is taken step by step from point A to B, let's discuss it in detail also. See, in the previous process which we have studied, a body is taken from point A to point B. In this process, say point A and B are located somewhere on x-axis and potential energy of body is given as a function of position. At every point, potential energy is changing. So, if the body is going from one point to another, say from A to B, and in between it is displaced by a distance dx by application of the field force F. So, we can simply state in displacing the body by dx, let du be the decrease in potential energy of system, then we can use minus du is equals to f dx. Because in displacement by dx, work done by the field is f dx, and due to this, field potential energy is decreased by du. So we can write minus du is equals to f dx, or du can be written as minus f dx. Or we can write f is equals to minus of du by dx, which can be vectorially written as f vector is equals to minus of du by dx I cap. This relation is very important for all of you to keep in mind, because this negative sign shows that force always acts in a direction where potential energy decreases. Like in gravitational field, we have just now studied. And this relation is valid for unidirectional variation in potential energy. Like here, we have taken potential energy variation only in x direction. If potential energy is varying in a two-dimensional or three-dimensional region, then the process will be a little different. We'll also discuss the process. Similar to this, if we talk about 3D region or in free space or 3D variation of potential energy, we use force vector is written as negative of del u. This del is called gradient operator, and it is also written as minus gradient of u. In this expression, this del is written as gradient operator, and this del is defined as del over del x I cap plus del over del y j cap plus del over del z k cap. In this expression, this small del, this is called partial derivative operator. Just like the case when you differentiate any physical quantity or differentiate a function, you use d over dx. Here we use del over del x because it is partial derivative operator. We differentiate with respect to x, keeping y and z or any other variable as constant. Similarly, del over del y is called differentiation with respect to y, keeping other variables as constant. It is known as partial differentiation. Similarly, del over del z is partial differentiation of a function with respect to z, keeping other variables as constants. So, we apply this operator over here. Here we can see the force vector in a 3D variation can be written as negative of, if you just use this del operator here, it will be del u over del x I cap plus del u over del y j cap plus del u over del z k cap. There are so many cases in which you can simplify it. Like for an example, if in a region u is given as 4x cube plus 3y square z, and we are required to find force vector in this region. Very easily you can get it if you just go for the solution. Force vector we can write as negative of del u over del x I cap, if we differentiate it with respect to x only, you can see what we'll be getting. It will be 12x square, and this term if we consider as a constant because we are partially differentiating u with respect to x, so it will become 0. So this into I cap, then minus will come in, is minus of del u over del y. If we differentiate this expression with respect to y, you can see this differentiation will become 0 and differentiation of this will become 6yz j cap, because here we are treating z as a constant only. Similarly, again minus will come in. When we differentiate this expression with respect to z, first term will certainly be equal to 0 after differentiation, keeping x as constant. In second term here, 3 and y square both we consider as constant, only z is here, which will have differential coefficient 1. So we can simply write it 3y square k cap. So we can simply state the force vector can be written as minus 12x square I cap minus 6yz j cap minus 3y square k cap. So this will be the answer to this question, and this is the way how we differentiate partially. So whenever you are given with the potential energy just varying with a single coordinate, then we use the expression force vector is equals to minus du by dx I cap, which we have studied on the previous sheet. And if potential energy is given as a function of all three coordinates in a space, you need to use this gradient form. This is called gradient form of force and potential energy, by which using partial differentiations you can get the final result of force.